Hey guys, welcome back to the Plytix Academy. I'm Bergen, and in this lesson, we're going to talk about data flows. Things are going to get very technical, and we have a lot of geeky ground to cover. So why don't you grab your favorite tea, coffee, or mate, sit back, relax, and let's dive right in. We'll start by looking at what data flows are and why they're important in product information management. Next, we'll cover the difference between internal and external data flows. And finally, we'll discuss the most common ways to create external data flows for PIMs: API connections, ERP connections, and channels. Understanding data flows is basically understanding how data moves from one location to another. In the context of product information management, it's looking at how data flows into, around, and out of a PIM. Data flows are often visualized by using a model or a diagram so that you can easily map out the entire process from where the data is born until it's viewed by your customers. Why are data flows important? Well, when it comes to e-commerce, product data isn't static, and it certainly doesn't stay in one place. Product data is in constant motion. For example, a keyword that works today may not be relevant tomorrow because of current events or general trends. Understanding your product data will help give you a clear picture of how your business operates and the technologies you'll need to employ to get your data where it needs to go. In order to understand your product data, you need to know where it comes from, who adds to or modifies your data, and how your data flows from one system to the next. So let's see what this might look like in action using the data flow model I showed you earlier. Your company's product data may originate from an ERP system. That stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. Once that data reaches the PIM, your sales, marketing, and finance team, just to name a few, will enrich and optimize your data. Finally, optimized data will leave the PIM to be shared with your clients, distributors, sales channels like Google Shopping, and other third parties. As you can see in our model, we've connected the ERP and PIM using an API. But when the data leaves the PIM and heads into Google Shopping, we use an XML feed. But don't worry if this sounds like a foreign language to you at this point. You'll understand everything a lot more clearly by the end of the lesson. Internal and external data flows. So now that we understand what a data flow is and how modeling data flows can help you gain a greater understanding of your business, let's look at how data flows work in the world of PIM. We're going to focus on two types of data flows, internal and external. An internal data flow is any data moving from one location to another within your PIM system. As you get more comfortable with PIM, you'll be using internal data flows on a daily basis. So here's a quick example. Remember when we talked about filtering attributes and how you could use your PIM to search for all the products that cost less than $20? Well, once you have your search results, you could generate and save a list called products under 20, and then use that list to create a custom catalog showcasing those budget-friendly products. With a PIM, you won't need any other system to do this because you can do the whole process within the very same platform. An example of this is data flowing from where you edit your product information to where you create your product catalog. That's an internal data flow. Next up, we have external data flows, which show the movement of data between your PIM and external locations. We've actually already seen two examples of this in our data flow model. The first is when data comes from another system like ERP and then is imported into PIM. And the second is when data originates in the PIM and is then exported into a third party, like sending product information to Google Shopping. Getting data from one system to another may look easy. We exchange data between systems on a daily basis by pressing send on an email or downloading a file on the internet. But there's actually a lot going on behind the scenes when these external data flows take place. There are three main connectors you can use to bring data into a PIM or send data out from a PIM, and we're going to look at each individually. The three connections we're going to cover are APIs, URL feeds, and FTPs. So let's start with APIs. API stands for Application Programming Interface, which is a connection that is built to allow two different systems or applications to talk to one another. A great metaphor for this to help us understand API is to think of shoe shopping. When you go shoe shopping, you usually browse through all the different models on the wall, and once you find the shoe you want to try on, you'll ask the employee for your size. Next, that employee will head to the back, sift through all the aisles and boxes to find the model and size you need, and bring it to you. In this metaphor, the shoe store employee is the API. basically the middleman that takes a request and retrieves exactly what you need and returns it to you. Every time you use an app on your phone or open a website, you are triggering APIs. Hundreds of shoe store employees retrieving thousands of shoes for you at lightning speed. You will hear the term API a lot when it comes to connecting systems. And in the world of PIM, it is a great way to sync everything up to automate the flow of data between all of the technology your company uses. That being said, building an API connection requires software development. So you'll need an IT expert or developer to set everything up. If you're not a software developer yourself, don't worry. You can simply pass on your PIM's API documentation to your development team and they'll be able to handle the rest. When it comes to PIM systems, building an API could be a great solution for your company. And we've already looked at the first one, connecting an ERP to your PIM. Other common situations where an API might come in handy include connecting your PIM to a website, to a mobile app, or to online marketplaces. At Plytix, we have an open API so you can develop custom connections between the Plytix PIM and any third party that also allows for API. If you want to read more, check out the link in our resource section at the end of this lesson. One quick note on ERPs before moving on. At Plytix, we strongly recommend building an API connection between your ERP and PIM to ensure that both systems share data automatically. For example, with API, you could set a rule that every time a new product is created in your ERP, that it's also sent to your PIM. And that's a lot more efficient than waiting around for someone in your company to send that data over manually. APIs are efficient, but they do require software development. So building an API isn't always the best way to share data between your PIM and other systems. There are two other connections we can use that are easier and faster: URL feeds and FTPs. So let's take a look at URL feeds first. A URL feed is another tool that passes data from one system to another. But unlike APIs, which are multi-directional, that means information flowing back and forth between two systems, a URL feed flows only one way. Creating a URL feed is a lot simpler than setting up an API connection, so you won't need an IT expert or developer to do any coding for you. In fact, it's so simple to create, you can usually set up a feed in a matter of minutes. But how do URL feeds work? First, imagine your company stores all of its product data in one spreadsheet, and at the end of the day, you have to email the latest version of that spreadsheet to all of the places where you sell your products. With a URL feed, you skip this step by automating when your file is sent and what information it contains. URL feeds are files that are hosted on a URL so that they can be accessed anytime you click on the link, meaning that anyone that has the link can get the latest product data. That way, no one has to send it manually. To set things up, you'll first need to decide exactly what information, like products and product attributes, you want to share. At this stage, you'll program any data transformations, like renaming or resizing images, so that the data matches any destination requirements. Next, you'll decide how often you want to update your feed. This could be weekly, daily, or even hourly. Finally, your PIM will create a custom URL so that anytime the URL is accessed, it will automatically download a file with all of the product information and transformations you included. With Plytix, you can create custom URL feeds for files using three different formats: a CSV or XLXX file, which are both types of spreadsheets, or an XML file, which is a special text file format. We've covered APIs and URL feeds, so there's only one connection type left to look at, and that's an FTP. FTP stands for File Transfer Protocol. And the way an FTP connection works is very similar to a URL feed. You'll start by preparing the file you want to share via FTP, which means you'll need to decide what product data you want to share, transform the data so that it meets your destination requirements, and program how often you'll send the data. However, the next step of how a file is sent is different from a URL feed. Instead of creating a URL link so the file can be accessed, the FTP connection will deliver your file directly into a folder inside a server. Let's imagine how this would work back in the day. Someone taking a freshly printed file from your desk and walking it down the hall to where you keep your file cabinets. Then opening the right drawer and putting that file exactly in the right folder where it belongs. An FTP connection does exactly this, but digitally. So instead of storing your file in the right folder in a file cabinet, Your file is delivered and stored on a server inside a digital folder. And just like with URL feeds, the file types you can send via FTP include CSV, XLXX, and XML. At this point, you might be wondering, if URL feeds and FTP connections are so similar, when should I use one and not the other? Well, it depends on who you're sending the data to and how they prefer the connection. Some systems are set up to work with URL feeds, and others will need to collect your data from a server. And that's why Plytix PIM allows for both options. And really, any PIM system should. All right, it's time for a recap before your quiz. In this lesson on data flows, we discuss what a data flow is and how understanding the way your product data moves from one system to another can give you better insight on your business. We talked about the difference between internal and external data flows, and we also introduced the three most common external data flow connection types: API connections, URL feeds, and FTPs. So now it's time to test what you've learned. Good luck, and see you in the next lesson on PIM add-ons.